Hey, it's your boy Asplat here. So, had you ever have a mania game like Overwatch, Dota 2, or League of Legends? Well, I'm here to talk about Downfall of Malzahar, the Prophet of the Void. You damn right! So, a mania and a champion, what do I mean with that? When your main is certain character in the game, it's the one you're gonna play the most, you like the most, and you really start to like have a connection with that champion. You really like the way he does his things. Like abilities wise, how it looks, those kind of things. For me, it was Malzahar in League of Legends. In the beginning of the game, I was like, well, I want to have a champion that looks pretty cool, and I will like, and his gameplay was really nice, so I chose Malzahar for my first champion. That was around season 4. Just look at this bloody background of his. He looks really cool, right? He has a scarf, he looks pretty swaggy, so that's why I chose him. And even after the major update, you can see right now, he looks more Void, a bit more terrifying in a way, perhaps. But he still looks pretty cool. I prefer his older look, but he still looks pretty cool. So let me explain what I mean with and downfall of. It's just when a certain champion or hero gets nerfed to the ground that they just cannot get out of the gutter anymore. Maybe it happened to one of your favorite heroes or champions? Well, let me know in the comments. Well, for me, it was Malzahar. So I will explain what Malzahar's abilities, and then I will go after all the nerfs and whatnot. So Malzahar Q is pretty much a spell that is damaged, like two little portals that come to one and silence an enemy. One of the few silences that actually are still in the game. His W is like a null zone that he can place on the ground that does percentage damage. His passive that spawns four links every now and then when you have done a couple spells. His E is like a damage over time, like a dot, but people call it space aids. Or even Ebola, I mean, that also sounds pretty fun. And his ult is just you press a target and you suppress it for like almost 2 seconds. And while suppressed, you cannot move. But it was his ult. This was old Malzahar. After the major update, they changed a lot. His new passive is that he has a spell shield. So when you hit him with a spell or attack, it won't do damage. And after a couple seconds, he will gain it back. Well, a couple seconds, a bit longer, but still. His Q still is the same as W is now that he spawns forward links. Forward links grow over time, get more armor, and has attack speed like his older one. And E is still the same. Well, now his new E, it refreshes. So if you have your E on a minion or a champion, it refreshes, so it will be like twice as much damage. But you have to hit it with your Q or your ultimate. So it won't happen too much. Then this new ult it's pretty much the same, but they added this null zone back to it, so you ult him and you still have that zone that does percentage damage. So these are all his abilities. Why do you pick Malzahar? He looks cool, his ability's pretty fun. He's more like a mage that is made for assassins, to be honest. Like, if you have to fight an assassin one-on-one, Malzahar most of the time wins. When he wants to go in, like an assassin wants to jump on one of your teammates, you just lock him down, you ult him, they're gone. That's why Malzahar's such a great pick. But he's not so great pick anymore. That's because of the shit ton of nerfs he got. So when does a champion most of the time get nerfed? It's either because people see him as a problem, or he's gonna be played in the big leagues. Get it? Leagues, League of Legends, huh? And that's not only League, it's probably still Overwatch and all those games, maybe even Smite. When they are like really popular in their high ranking tournaments, the companies like in this case, right, Retro Games, see that as a problem. They're like, well, I guess he's a bit too strong. He was not really that strong, to be honest, but they nerfed him quite a bit, so pro players couldn't play him. I know it maybe sounds like I'm overreacting and ranting a bit too much, but I really seriously love this champion. Like, I even got this ice skin. Of course, I do. I all like the ice teams, and even got a chroma skin for his ice skin as well, so that looks really cool. Just look at the gold shininess, even his foilings look pretty dope. So let's look at the nerfs. He's gonna get hit like one after another, like another one, like oof, 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 you know, the whole time. So let's see the first one. So it all started about in the mage update. I was talking about it before, 6.9. All of the mages, not all of them, but like a select few got changed and updated. Malzahar was one of them. And beginning I was like, ooh, that could be really scary because Malzahar, the old Malzahar before the update, was pretty good, to be honest. He was like definitely one of the better champions in the game. Even before the update, he got a little nerf at 5.9. He got his Kyo mana increased, W mana increased, Aether damage against monsters decreased, and his Nil Zone that maximum damage was less as well. So 6.10. Well, his passive got nerfed even less. Like the cooldown went on higher, so you have to wait like a pretty long time. When you get attacked, it's probably like 20 to 30 seconds. You just have to like try to avoid damage. If not, you're gonna get hit quite a bit. But that was not too bad in comparison to patch 6.14. Well, his movement speed got decreased by only 5, but it's still something. In his basic attack range from changed from 550 to 500. And overall, this was his worst nerf of all of them. Like, when you change the general attack range of a champion, that means quite a bit. Malsa is a mage, so most of the time he plays against either assassin at a bit shorter range, so he has better range so he can poke him down, or other mages. So with having less attack range, that means other mages outrange him, but means quite a bit. Not generally in spells, only with basic attacks. You need to get close to them to basic attack the minions to farm them most of the time. So now they can hit you way easier, but will hurt Malsa quite a bit in the laning phase. I still dislike this so much to do this, but I don't think they will like buff him ever again. Then at 6.15, they nerfed his passive again, yet it was still not too low, I guess. They still nerfed him, especially in the mid to late game. Then at patch 7.3, they changed the four links a bit. They spawn a bit, like the what's it called, the distance. It's like less, so they are getting closer to you. It also takes a little bit longer when you spawn them. And overall, they have a little bit less armor, I think. So they die fast. Not only are the four links changed, normally before the update, they would like grow like two times. First time they get bigger, they get more armor, so they are harder to kill. Secondly, they get attack speed, so whenever they are running around someone, they are kind of scary, you know? But now they are like weak as fuck. Like one basic attack, one is dead. Like if you spawn three in the laning phase, the enemy just has to use an AoE spell. Every champion has an AoE spell, so you cannot really use one of your abilities. You only have like four, and then you have your passive. But still, that's not much. Like, you only have like two spells really to work with Malsa in the laning phase. That's your Q and your E. Like, minions die and you're pretty high cooldown, so you won't use it too often. And that nerf was in 7.8. But that's why the four links got changed. Okay, let me see. 7.11. His Q cast time is a little bit less, so that's better, but still, most of the time you use your Q and you're already dead, right? You can see your Q, but it won't connect, really annoying. The AP ratio on your E got changed, got up a little bit higher, was nice, so a tiny little bit buff. Then they, what was actually a pretty good buff, they changed his R, so he has his beam damage again. It's not like how it used to be, I think. Before the update, it was like 250 level 1, 350 level 2, and then like maybe 500 level 3. It was quite a bit, so it did nice damage. And now it just has his Nil Zone and his beam, so it has some beam damage of 125, 215, 375, which is pretty decent. And you have, of course, your Nil Zone, which is under your oil, that does percentage damage. Which is not like as much as it was before, but it was still, you know, like his old oil, but a little bit worse. Then at 7.12, his Q damage got decreased by quite a bit. Like, when I show you on patch, you can see on the pictures, like, what they changed. So I won't go over all the little details. His R damage got decreased by quite a bit. His AP ratio got decreased as well. And the distance got changed a little bit as well, I guess. Like, you have this, like, QSS. It's like a magical item, but it's purely to, like, counter and CC ability. Everyone will use it against Malsa, and I hate this item so much. I never had a problem with that item until I played Malsa, which was pretty much the first champion in the game that I bought. And so I hate that item so much. Like, your ult, they can just cleanse your ult with that item, and they can walk freely inside to kill you. One thing I have to explain about this ult, while you're ult, you're standing still, so your opponent's also standing still because he's getting suppressed. But in that time, in teamfights, when you're standing still, you're gonna get killed if your team doesn't follow up on it. Then at patch 7.11, his 4 lanes got changed once again. They cost more mana, they have a high cooldown, and they can only summon a couple. Like, most of the time you summon 2, and if you use 2 spells, you can summon 3. And the cast range got decreased yet again. Then at pet 7.24 his ult got changed again, less damage and less AP ratio. Patch 8.2, like look at how many patches one after another, he's just getting nerfed. He maybe get like a little trigger, maybe buff him in a slight, but in general it's only nerfed. So 8.2, what do they nerf? They nerfed his AP ratios of his Q got decreased by quite a bit in his ult, and the crest also got pretty high cooldown on it now. It's just really annoying. Even if you look at my profile, you can see I have like this Chroma Master icon, I have like the Snowy Splash, I have the most mastery points. I'm like, I'm really committed to this guy, but always when I play him, it's just really hard to play him and put him off. I can give you some tips. It's like, this is my build that I'm using right now. Like, I either go like heavy AP with like Vault of Age and Death Kipper and those kind of items. Or I go more within the synergy kind of build, like Leon's Crystal Set and Ludens to get like more synergy, more damage, and a bit more HP depending what you want to do. Playstyle wise, I could definitely recommend you playing early game really safe, try to jungler to come to help you, and just play to the mid or late game. That is when you kind of can shine again. And these are the runes I'm using right now. I'm using most of the time Arcane Comet, but I think Ari could be good as well. Mana Flow Ban, because his mana problems quite big. A bit more cooldown with Transcendence and Swords for the extra damage. You can also go for like AP over time sort of Swords, also pretty good. Then I most of the time use like Domination as second. Sorcery is probably like a must have. You can also use like the Spellbook probably as the first one, but second one, Domination. I go for Ultimate Turn to just get like a bit more CDR on your ult. It's always nice. And Taste of Blood, just because a bit more lifesteal, like training. That's probably the way to go. And then like little runes, I just go for flat 10% CDR over time, a bit more adaptive force, and a bit more HP. That makes up for a bit of his nerfs in some way. But if you ever played against the Malzahn nowadays, how does it feel? Like, you win most of the time, right? He's not that good. If you ever seen a Malzahn in your game, how do they play? Like, do they lose a lot? Let me know, because always when I see Malzahn play, it's either me playing him or someone else, and it's straight up losing, because he's like, well, he just wanted to counterpick someone, and then he's like, damn, this champion, he's so weak, what happened? Well, this happened. Did you ever think about Malzahn getting nerfed so hard like he's right now? I don't think any champion has been nerfed this hard like Malzahn, like one way or another. It's like an in-game joke, like better nerf early out, or way Ryze always getting changed. Like, I don't think the changes are that often as Malzahn gets nerfed. And as a main, Malzahn, it just feels really bad for me. So just let me sum it up about the nerfs that they changed his cooldowns, like all the cooldowns on all his abilities pretty high. AP scaling ratios, like the more AP you get, the more damage your abilities do. They got changed, like they got lower, so more HP is still not that much damage. His flat damage is got also, like his base damage also got down. Attack speed and movement speed got a little bit down as well, so overall cooldown damage, that's the most important things. They just got shit on. I can never really see Malzahn being played in like the big tournaments like he was before, just because how bad he is right now. I mean, most of the time people only play him for his ult, but you have so many champions who can do like similar things, like lockdown wise, like Lissandra, Lux, Morgana, you know, those kind of champions. So for like the 21 Malzahn mains that are still out there, kudos to you, man. I respect you a lot. If you do want to play with me, everyone, like, you can add me. I'm playing on AU West most of the time. I also stream quite a bit on Twitch, so follow me on that. This is just my little rant. I'm sorry that that's maybe a little bit longer than it should be, but it's been Iceblade, and I will see you all later.